All right, welcome to Counter Slam, where we discuss anything and everything, War Machine, Hordes, and the Iron Kingdoms. Counter Slam, of course, is our live broadcast where we get a chance to interact with you, the viewers. So feel free to chat away on our chat. We can see what you're typing, and we can get a chance to answer in real time. And every week, we also play a live game and get a chance to answer your questions that way, too. So we got Jake here manning the keyboard, so as you type, he can type back to you. You'll notice we are short one person, which is Joyce, unfortunately. We do want to extend a happy Father's Day. Welcome to all the fathers that are watching, too. Hi, Dad. And
hey, Dad.
Hey, Dad.
We also want to give a special shout-out to the fathers that we have here. Jason's a father. My brother's a father. He's manning the cameras right now. So
we've stolen two fathers away from their families today. Yeah. What an accomplishment. Yeah.
We are so evil. I tell you what. Apparently today is also Silly Hat Day. As you can see, I'm just kidding, guys.
By silly, you mean awesome, because this hat is the most amazing hat ever.
Please don't hit me with the keyboard. I'd appreciate that.
You know, I've told you the story of this hat, right? You know, this hat was purchased 20 years ago, and it survived. It survived three world wars. It's passed from between 13 different owners. I hear it's cursed.
Is that when it was in style?
hey, this hat is still totally in style.
Now you say it's cursed. That probably would explain a lot about your table playing over there at War Machine.
Just a little bit, maybe. If I lose, it's the fault of the hat. If I win, it's also the fault of the hat. So. Okay.
Well, let's do introductions. Let's start over here with you, and let's talk about, give your name, and maybe what caster is the most like you.
Okay, well, I'm the hat. I'm Jeremy. Let's see, a caster that's most like me. My hat's better than his hat. My caster that's most like me.
We're going to have to bow this out. Right?
I'm gonna have to say that it's probably Mosar. Aside from the fact that he's a crotchety old man, and I'm not quite there yet.
But one day.
One day.
It gives you something to aspire to, Jeremy.
Let's see, Mosar, he doesn't have any respect for the lives of his soldiers. He just sort of throws them away. And I do that a bit.
I do murder infantry quite a bit a lot.
Yeah, you
play,
do. So. They do tend to die in droves. He's a jerk. Huge, huge jerk. Although I don't know really how that applies to me.
One day we'll figure it out.
And he just spends all his time running around on the backfield, never actually getting into the fight, just like never playing fair, staying far away from people, being a bully. Again, I don't know why, but I'm really drawn to that, and I feel he kind of, maybe he's a little like me.
I like that.
What about you?
Well, I would say...
name. What's your name, sir?
Who are you? First of all, who are you, Mr. Man? Well, next to me?
In the intro, my name is Jason, I play trolls, and I would say Borka, because I like my beer. I'm educated in the ways of beer snobbery. But I'm not much of a brawler, so I'd say
he's a lover, not a fighter.
Doomshaper, a grumpy old man.
Racist grumpy old man.
I am the oldest. Just because I don't like you doesn't make me.
He likes Koreans. That's why he likes to hang out with us.
Yeah. He likes everybody on this side of the table, at least.
He apparently has a huge distaste for Puerto Ricans like myself.
I'm Eric. And my favorite model is...
Oh, by the way, I think you forgot that.
Oh. It's Rias, I guess, for a couple of reasons. One is you can tell my twin brother walks on here. Sorry about taking you away from your family tonight, too. I didn't really mean to do that.
You suck.
Okay. So, Rias is my favorite I think is the one who's most like me, and she's my favorite caster, too. But I think it's also... one, because I'm a twin, and I'm not like the Denegra Haley twin. I don't hate my twin, so we don't have that aspect going. We get along really well, so we're a little
after
more.
Today,
insane.
Your twin might hate you.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. But I think Chris and I are a lot alike. But I have to give him props. He is a little bit smarter than me. I mean, he's the one who's helping me fix all this stuff that we keep breaking around here. And I'm just more like Batman, so I got to be like Rias.
So what you're saying is that you have the twin who's like who's awesome and amazing and does cool things, and you're the bad twin that's sort of a failed ninja?
Now, people ask all the time if I am the evil twin, and I always tell them, that's a misnomer. There is no good one.
There is no good twin.
So, yes, the evil one. But no, I think Rias is my favorite caster and the one most like me, so I'm going to go with that. What about you?
I'm Jake from the... You probably already know from the intro. I want to say the old witch.
Please. Explain this to me, Jake. What do you do in your off time?
Having a little bit of trouble.
I go around and tell people, like, you're the next king, and
really?
Take people's soldiers and go around and do things.
How many times has he told you that you're the next king?
I've never.
I think this is sort of breaking down, Jake.
He said old witch, and this just got really awkward. I don't know what it is.
But all seriousness, I'll say Karchev, and two reasons, fluff-wise. First one, right now, if you remember the fluff, he is being dismantled by Krix. My girlfriend is the Krix.
I love it.
And we never saw Jake again.
It makes so much more sense now. It really does. Yeah. A much better answer than the old witch, I'll give you that. So.
Honestly, when Joyce gets a hold of you, bad things are going to happen.
All right, so, okay. Which caster is Joyce most like? So she's not here.
Ooh, that's a good
go ahead.
Remember, she can't dispute this. And yes. Even if she does via text, we're just going to ignore that.
Just record it for her.
No, I see Terminus, this is going maybe? On. No, let's not do that. I don't want to sleep on the couch.
Here. Oh, apparently she's on.
Oh, she's on?
What? I am here.
What? No, we're just going to ignore that.
No.
Continue, what? Jake.
Oh, yeah.
How well do you know Joyce? Which caster is she?
So what's the next topic?
You don't have to live with her.
That is true.
I'll be sleeping on the couch.
Yeah, that's a...
I don't know, actually, but think about it.
Well, you know what?
She does enjoy the statistics.
We'll give her some time to ruminate on this, and we'll have her say it next week.
I'll say Molten Nebula.
She said good answer. Well, how about this? Which caster do you think you're the most like, then, if you can answer us? I'm going to say she's going to say Scar.
High heels. Is that a horny pirate chick with a whip?
I know it's not a caster, but I would.
Well, you know what?
Bloat throw.
Scar does have a great rack.
Aww. Well, you're not somebody's friend anymore. Gosh.
I don't have to sleep on a cat.
Not Scar, really? Oh.
I'll say Marchenebra, since she's more focused on the science aspect.
She's got lots of arms.
Ah, that's a good point. She's pretty smart, too.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Well.
She is pretty smart, so Marchenebra will work.
Well, smarter than some of us, than others.
Well,
that got awkward.
Next topic.
Episode two, awkward.
Well, tonight we have an interesting topic that I want to go over, and it is we're going to talk about useless models. We're going to put quotes around that, useless models, because...
So you mean like Jason here?
I'm a model?
This particular model of Irish.
Do I do my little turn on the catwalk?
We do things between each other outside of the show.
On the catwalk? Do a little turn on the catwalk?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I was thinking more in lines of playing models that we actually use. But useless models.
Oh, you mean this game that we're here to talk about?
Yeah, the game we're here to talk about.
Oh.
Yes. So, useless models, what models do your people play your faction consider to be useless? And we'll
I know the
take
answer.
Turns
I know the
here.
Answer.
Well, let's talk about Circle for a moment. You talk about your faction.
Come on, Jim.
All right, the most obvious answer, and it's probably a tie, is I'm going to start with the first one. Is the Reeves of Orboros. Oh man, do people hate the Reeves of Orboros. They are considered widely to be the most terrible unit in all of Circle, if not the entire game. There's many reasons for this. Most of them are centered around the fact that their stat line's kind of below average. But I, being a contrarian and having something of a hipster complex, refuse to accept that they're actually bad. And through a lot of playtesting, I think that I've kind of figured out that they actually can be useful. And Jason has seen firsthand that that is in fact true.
When half the dogs and the UA and the solo
right.
And
there we go. That's the thing that makes them good, is that the Reeves of Orboros, if you just look at them, you know, for what they are, with the stats they've got, you know, they're rat 5, which is kind of meh. They're only POW 10, which is really meh. They seem pretty bad. But then you start taking other things with them, right? You take a Reeve Hunter, and suddenly they get camouflage, and they can go up to defense 17 while in cover, while in concealment, which is really good. You take the Werewolves, and then they get the Sikkim Reeves charge. So you shoot something with a Reeve of Orboros, and then a Werewolf just comes flying out of nowhere and charges it, and that's supremely annoying. It's good for picking off solos. Or for tying them up. I've used both of those tactics to kill Fenris.
Yeah.
And to kill, what's the big old guy on the...
Horthal.
Horthal. Yeah, the big dude with the hammer on a Tuffalo. Hate that guy.
Yeah, he's pretty rough.
But, I don't know, it's great. You can kill people with them, or you can tie them up for a while. And, of course, Circle players are starting to come around on this unit, mostly because Epic Morvana exists now. Mm. And it's been, you know, it's been discovered that, hey, a caster which just gives control area-wide concealment to a unit with Hunter that gets extra defense while in concealment might be a good thing. Huh. So they run around to defense 17 all over the place. They're highly accurate because, oh no, I missed one of my shots. I'm just going to reroll that because I'm Epic Morvana. It makes them really good. So yeah, there's that one unit that everyone hates. But I'm, like I said, there's ways around that. Okay. I think the other unit that everyone says is really useless, and I don't really have a great defense for them, is probably the Sentry Stone and Mannequins. I think everyone here has probably played against them at least once.
Yeah, oh yeah. I mean, I think they're kind of cool-looking models, but...
So yeah, it's the stone, it's got the little mannequins, they run around...
How many points are those?
They do silly stuff. It's 3 points.
3 points?
Which seems like one more point than most people would want it to be. Like, it would be better if it were 2 points. The weird thing is they seem really bad, because, you know, they're only like Mat 5, Rat 4, their spray and their melee attacks aren't super powerful, you know, and they don't really seem all that good for 3 points.
They literally are sticks tied together the ropes.
Right, yes, they are. But you know what I've discovered, and like, it's weird, because I almost never put them into lists, because I'm like, man, I don't have 3 points to spend for this mostly worthless unit, but every time I do actually put them in a list, they're amazing. They always do something good for me. And it's for like two reasons, because first reason is, a lot of times I take them against people who've never seen them, and they just, like, they don't realize that there's, like, a POW 12 rat or range 8 spray that can come out of one of those little mannequins. That takes people off guard all the time. Or they don't realize that I can, like, you know, put the stone up next to their caster and take a fury away from their caster. And they're like, oh, now I can't make a transfer.
When I was playing Menoth, I got assassinated by a mannequin. Essentially.
Oh, my gosh. You're still playing this game?
Well, it's the first time I played Circle. And I was ignoring it, because if you look at the stat line...
You're terrible.
And it ran up next to Amon and died, which made a forest, and then Epic Balder teleported in.
Ah, there you go. The other big gotcha is an Epic Balder teleport through one of those forests. It's absolutely hilarious.
And then after that game, I knew all of Circle's tricks.
And he's never lost to Circle again.
Except the times he's lost to me. But you know what the funny thing is, though, that... Like you just pointed out, there's some gotchas with that unit. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times you'll win games entirely because of that unit, because people don't know what they do. But you take it against people that do know what they do, and I find that they're still good. Like, you don't have the gotcha factor anymore, but suddenly you have this unit that they, like, people freak out about because there's some little trick it can pull off that'll ruin their day, and they just put way too much effort into killing it. Mm-hmm. And that stone has got, like, armor 18 and 8 hitboxes, and it's stealth. That thing is not easy to kill.
Yeah.
And it just keeps making mannequins every turn. No, it's like a weirdly terrible unit that has never performed badly for me. And I can't really explain why, but it just is a lot more useful than people give it credit for.
What about you, Jason? You played a number of factions, like, I don't know, maybe thinking in more lines of the mercs and trolls, at least the mercs side that you play.
I know what troll one, I would say. And I don't own the model, so I can't go into, like, what Jeremy went, as far as Reeves are.
It's Skinner, isn't
it? It is the Skinner. And I think the problem, I think the Skinner should have been sort of like a UA for the scouts. But for 2 points, it just competes with a lot of stuff that is just way better in a troll list. The trolls already have to take a lot of support. But he's got decent stats, but he's essentially got one attack on a non-reach PNS-9 weapon master, and he's got dismember. So against a war beast, he's rolling 5 dice.
Wow. Wait, and people think he's one of the useless models?
Well,
the thing is, he's delivering him is really hard.
Delivering him, and if he misses, you know.
Okay.
And he's only Mat 7, right?
I believe so. Yeah, he's got duck, which sort of helps him if he goes up to a war beast and whiffs, but...
Yeah, sort of like Pendrake, he's got that too, which makes him nice.
Yeah. But it's just, for 2 points, he just really competes for a lot of stuff. Now, do I think that he should be 1 point? No, I think for what he does, 1 point would be, a steal.
Sure.
Well, what is his
5 points
allowance?
Of dice for one point.
Two? So your field allowance two? Because if you were one point, so. I would always take two of them.
Now, if he had, like, maybe two skinny knives, you know, if, like, he had a second attack.
Kind of like a Manhunter, like, two attacks.
Yeah, I could see possibly feeling him.
Well, the important thing to remember, a lot of why people don't like him, though, is, like, yeah, he rolls that five dice, like you said, his only power and strength is nine. So people, that really scares people. So, like, he's only good at damaging war beasts.
But the thing is, a lot of war beasts got low armor, unless you're fighting Scorn. Wow. And satyrs. Yeah. Never mind.
Scorn and troll war beasts have a lot of armor.
Yeah.
And circle war beasts have a lot of defense.
Well, trolls can have a lot of armor. I wouldn't say base 12, 18.
He's probably best against Legion, actually, because Legion is a nice combination of low armor and low defense that the Skinner could probably hurt them really bad.
On the big beast, I mean, Carnivian gets it, you know, with spiny growth, maybe makes them a little bit harder to hurt. But their defense 11 doesn't help them at all in any game that I play. It's very rare that those guys don't get easily hit, you know, a little harder to damage. But then the flying ones are really hard to hit and actually can take a hit.
That's 14.
Yeah. Even 14 armor, you know, 17, 18. Those are pretty
good. And I can't remember, but if he is Mat 7, then he's going to whiff a lot on that. So as far as mercs, I'm not as familiar with them as I am with trolls, but one unit that always, I guess from the name alone, always interests me was Crows Cutthroats.
Ooh, those guys are awesome in Crix, by the way.
But they have...
They're a Crix unit.
...a lowish rat, and their whole thing is against living models, and they have to be in their back arc to do it, and you have to start in their back arc. So delivering those
is... That's why Scabbers loves them. Telekinesis, just start telekinesis, everybody turn them all around, and they just come in and they're rolling. They said, I think it averages like 25 points of damage to the guy. It's ridiculous.
Are they also weapon masters?
They have poison.
They have poison.
That's what it is. Poison, and the backstab.
Yeah.
Oh, five dice on a charge. Yeah.
But they're only... Gain two, do they?
I don't think so.
No, okay.
they're only...
Because they have a...
Are they rat
long
six
range
or seven?
And melee.
Mm-hmm. Rat six or seven.
On the crows?
Yeah.
No. I think it's five.
Matt, sorry.
I know they have a low rat, but the leader in the UA, he has high.
The leader is a little bit higher,
So they're like Matt six.
Yeah,
probably.
I don't know that I like Mets, but of course they're designed around backstabbing you, so technically whenever they get that off, they're actually Mat 8.
Right.
Yeah. And plus,
but still.
Plus you have, like, if you have playing Crix, minus defense, or, I don't know, who can, like a Menoth.
If there's any faction that can polish turds, it's Crix. Crix is the faction that takes Mechanoth rolls, who are just god-awful terrible in any other faction and makes them actually decent.
Hey, your casters are the ones that have to go around with the doggy bags picking up poo in the forest, okay? Not my guys. We don't have dogs.
That unit needs ambush. The ambush, I'd pay like 12 points for it.
Okay, Privateer Press, please don't ever actually give them ambush.
Mark 3, just jot this down for notes, Privateer Press. Mark 3.
Ambushing Crows Cutthroats.
Same abilities, just ambush. Gotcha. Yeah, okay. I mean, well, since we don't have anybody here right now who plays Menoth at the moment, I mean, what about Menoth? What do you think?
I never had the use for it, but I would say, and Jose likes these, the Allegiant Order of the Fist guy.
Which one?
He's a solo. He's got the, I think it's called Shifting Sands stance, so if you miss him with a ranged attack, he gets to move. And he gets a buff to his defense. He's weapon master with his feet, but again, it's like the Skinner, it's a lowish, it might be like 8 or 9 weapon master feet.
Weapon master feet, yes!
But with like...
What about Amon Raza?
I love Amon Raza. I'm one of the... when I played Menoth, I was the underdog guy. I liked Amon Raza. I liked the High Reclaimer.
Yeah, but everybody, see, if you know, I probably hear more complaints about those casters than I hear about anything else in all of
Amon's problem is he relies on his defense to keep him alive, which is only 16, and coming from, you know, like playing Thyra,
but
who has defense 17.
It never goes down, even if he's knocked down.
True,
really cool.
But even boosted blast damage can kill Amon. Like, you know, you get him against the behemoth or something like that, where you can boost him even if he's behind a wall and he's defense 20. Ha ha! Come at me. Oh, I'm going to deviate one. I'm going to boost that. You know, his armor is only 14, 12 or 14.
Yeah, he's got a little bit of the old man stats going on.
Yeah.
Wow.
But he runs Dervish's, Jack's, you know, amazing.
Yeah, synergy. Synergy's super good with Dervish's and the choir. Turns
and
out.
Mobility.
Turns out.
Well, I'm sorry to
do that. No, I was just saying, I've tagged a Vlad 3 with a Dervish on the end of a synergy chain, and it was like Matt 14, PNS 23 or something like that. So,
I play, you know, three factions. I got Legion, Crix, and Gators. Gators, I pretty much have to field almost everything in Gators every game, so there's not a lot that I don't
Bone
use.
Bone Swarm.
The Bone Swarm has kept my casters alive, though, by, you know, kind of as like a little bodyguard, because anything within 2 inches, you know, basically gives it like Ashen Veil. So, you know, that helps the Gators a lot. I've even found myself taking the Bone Swarms even more often now.
Faction is just bad.
The Swamp Horde,
and you don't have many options. You got to take it all.
A little less. Eh. I mean, he's good with Rask.
The Swamp Horde.
His animus is nice.
Love the
elasticity
model.
Is amazing.
I love the model.
But
I love the model, but I've heard the same thing.
Yes, but the problem is when you're playing Gators, I mean, you can literally build the same list and take whatever this different casters is. You're going to take one or two units of the Gatorman posse, and you're going to have one or two or even three of the Rasslers. That's pretty much your list. And then you've got your little solos that kind of intermix.
Well, it's just like nothing in the faction. So.
Yeah, it's a relatively small faction. So it's hard to say what's useless in there. But I find myself not taking the Swamp Horror and the Spitters very much at all. Those tend to be probably the two lesser things I use. The Spitters are great. I like them. They can't take blast damage. But with the one shot.
Oh, yeah. The Spitter might be the closest thing to useless
it's okay.
in the faction.
But it's nice because it's sort of like a Ravagor, but it does great, but it's so easy to hit. It's ridiculous.
You had a Spitter kill my Pureblood once.
I did. I remember that.
Aha. So there you go, people.
And I turned my Spitter into Koopa, which you can see later on, too, which is really funny. I painted
Oh, see, there you go. Like they can't be terrible because they make for great conversions.
They do make
for there's somebody who is making who's making one into a Blastoise. Like a Pokemon.
Wow.
It's hilarious.
Yes. Well, I've seen Ninja Turtles. Somebody did the four Ninja Turtles with them. I thought that was hilarious. Someone did I did the Koopa. Yeah, they probably are the most fun to actually tweak with. So mm-hmm. I got to give them that. So they're not completely useless, I guess. But on the other two factions on Crix, I don't see a lot of people taking the Pirates a lot. The Revenants. I love the Black Wings Ghost Rider, but a lot of people don't take them either.
I think you're missing out on the thing that is probably the most obvious hated unit in all of Crix, the Cephalix.
I was getting to
there.
That. That's what I was going to say. I don't see a lot of people play the Pirates. I don't see a lot of people complaining about the Pirates. The Cephalix, on the other hand, a lot of people are upset. And for some reason, there's really a fascination on the Crix forums about us getting a Cephalix caster. I don't want a Cephalix caster, if at all possible. I really don't want one. You know what? Morton Ebra, I would love to see an epic Morton Ebra. I think that'd be a lot of fun. Just something that really hits convergence, or where she has convergence abilities. It would be ridiculously cool. So, like, where she, you know, all of her jacks get an ability that she has, that type of thing, you know, synergy where they have, replace all their Matt and Rat with what her Matt and Rat is, you know, that type of thing. That could be really
cool. Field Marshal, yeah. Oh, God.
So, that'd be fun. But anyway, that's not what we're here to talk about. Useless models, yes, I think the Cephalix are probably the biggest one that people just don't like. What's funny is that that unit, though, someone even commented on the forums once, is that our worst unit still has Eyeless Sight and Tough. The Drudges, so I thought that was really funny. So there's that. I've been taking the Cannon Crew a couple times, but it hasn't really done much. I have a heart. It's like I really want the cannon to succeed. It's a range 14 shot. It's got ghost shot, which is nice. But man, I see your guys as cannons. You guys, it just irks me. 20 inch shots and things. Whatever. That's not cool.
Yeah, at least you have an artillery piece. My faction does not.
In its present form, I really don't like the way Privateer Press has their artillery set up. I know some people are making like the Sunburst Crew from Minoff work for them and stuff like that. But honestly. And I know it for 3 points it is a bit overpowered, but the only artillery I'll field is the Commodore Cannon.
My artillery.
Yeah, the freaking Commodore cannon is like the most outrageous piece. It's got a 20-inch auto knockdown slot.
I have the mortar team and Rat 3. A lot of people don't field them because the Rat 3 kills it.
If that Merc cannon could be fielded in other factions, other armies, that would be the best 3 points in the game, I think. It's ridiculous.
Probably.
Your mortar team really hates going up against Epic Krieger.
I have a story with my mortar team, just because, like, it's one of those... Well, after you're down, explain it, because it's one of the less people...
Yeah, all right, move on. You got another question.
With Legion... Now, it was funny, because Legion actually has quite a number of units and models that people don't really like to take. I mean, we have the Skater crew, which is our catapult, which really, I've never seen one. I don't know anybody who owns one. They're just not good.
Your gargoyle unit.
Yes, that's what I was getting to. Grotesques, yes.
They're like Command 5 or something stupid.
Yes, the Grotesques are another one of the people. I actually played against somebody who played them. They didn't do anything. I completely wiped them off the table. But
they're a fine unit. Yeah. Obviously, they're amazing.
And Proteus, a lot of people don't like that.
A lot of people don't like Proteus. Some people don't even like Typhon, honestly. But Proteus is definitely the redhead stepchild of the larger beasts. For 12 points, no.
He's a shepherd.
No. He needs to be, that dude needed to be like 9 points.
He's 12 points?
Yeah, he's a 12-point character beast.
He does have 5 fury, which is nice, and he's got the grab and drag, which is cool, but he's the only thing we have with the grab and drag, so it does, and I can only take one, so it's not, it just doesn't hit hard
enough. And his drag is only like 6, or his range is 6 inches.
Yeah, it's not a long, drag. Now, granted, with Elilith, it can get to 10 inches with
the
snipe.
Well, that does give him an 11-inch non-charging threat range, though.
It does, but I just... his
no, wait, claws, 12 inch, because he's speed 6.
His claws are only 16, though, and against Jax, it just doesn't do the damage I need it to do. I've rarely found it that just if I'm going to spend 11 points, to spend 1 point less and get a Carnivian, I will take that any day.
I'll just take 4 steps.
I tried out Proteus, and the only time I have successful time with him is Assassin Kill. Just, drag the caster towards him, he just...
I think he could make a decent second-line beast, He's not necessarily the first guy you send in, but he can help you keep distance with your beast because he's got
I'm not going to say that he's useless. He's not useless, but he's the one people don't like, I'd say the least. He definitely has his places, and people who do play him love him to death. I think that kind of really is what it gets to a lot of these useless models. A lot of people, people tend to judge as useless. There are some people who just love those models and will play them like
that. Well, you know what I've found? It's the reason why I always make the effort to use things like the Reaves of Orboros or the Century Stone, and I really found that there are not any models in this game that are just completely useless. Yeah. Like everything can be good.
Now I will say
not everything you're gonna take in every game. I don't take the Century Stone in every game, and I'm sure you wouldn't ever take a Skinner in every game, but that doesn't mean that they're completely useless models.
Yeah. Well, the Archangel is funny. A lot of people, I wouldn't say the Archangel is useless. Now its Animus is completely useless.
All right, that one I had to think a long, hard time. But I had lots of arguments over it, and finally I was swayed to believe that that Animus is just kind of bad.
It's terrible. I don't know what they were thinking. Why couldn't it should have been like consume, where just everything in its melee range just gone. Like gets set on fire, like takes a POW 12 fire roll or something. I don't know, and gets set on fire. That'd be cool, but...
I'm going to intervene a little for a minute. Joyce replied, the Crix.
Yeah.
She likes the Blood Orchards, the Black Banes, and the Ghosts.
The Organ.
Yeah, she said a lot of people in the forums don't play them as much, but she thinks they're great, and she's going to try them.
What I like about her. She's playing the models that I don't have, which is cool, because then that gives a lot of variety to when we start playing our games and stuff.
I think part of the issue that Crick sometimes faces with that is, in a world, or, in a faction where you have, Bane Thralls, Bane Knights, Tartarus, Satixis Raiders, and a Satixis Raider Captain, it seems really hard to actually consider anything else good. Because you've got these amazing models, and everything else is just it's not Bane Thralls.
In my opinion, I think what it is the meta. It's just people want to use the meta list just because, these guys are so good. They can do this. They answer a lot of the problems.
Okay. Well, what about Kador? What do you think? What do you hear on the...
Reading from the forums, and it's funny that when I was doing research, I was like, okay, which model I should get because I'm low on funds and stuff like that. I went after the mortar crew, the bombardiers, and I don't have these guys, but assault commandos. and I want to try them out.
You're just picking all the things that everybody hates.
I'm the same thing with Joyce. We're like, okay, Winter Guards are great, Banes are great, but you know, we don't want to rely on the. I mean, they're good for a reason, but I don't want to use them as a crutch.
Yes.
Ah, there you go.
And by the
yeah.
way, Banes are great. I
oh
love
God,
Banes.
Don't listen to him.
Assault Commandos will make Minoth and Legion cry, though.
Oh yeah, and they're great against Legion and Minoth because of their alchemical mask. They're immune to fire and they're immune to corrosive. So, and they can shield wall
what?
If they have the Cobneck, the Iron Pen Cobneck.
Okay, I'm
going to
go
you.
Cry now in the corner. Jeez, what in the world?
But the bad thing about them, unless you have, if you play Epic Vlad, he can cast Hand of Fate to roll 3 dice and take the lowest. Because their rat is like 5. They're low. And they specialize in, you know, this gas bomb. When, if it hits a target, it does, you know, AoE cloud. If it miss, it does nothing. That's what killed it. Another thing, Bombardiers, they're 11 points. All the Manowar's troops are 9 points. I like them because I use them in my second wave, and I use it on you and you, where they're just like, they're behind Iron Fangs, or my Shock Troopers just launching grenades. I don't care. I'm going to hit your infantry. Pal 14, range 12, I think.
Yeah.
They might even do something against me if I stop taking Epic Cruiser against you.
Yeah. And another thing, and the Mortar Team. Yes, they're light artillery. They have a Rage Finder if they're base to base, but they have this thing where they get -4 on their rat. So in truth, they
yeah,
have...
Yeah, they're inaccurate.
Inaccurate. So total, rat of 3.
God,
but,
I love the inaccurate. I appreciate the inaccurate, honestly.
But I use Epic Arrus with Fire for Effect buff on him, uh-huh. on them. Roll 3 dice, I'm guaranteed to hit with a POW, 16?
Mm-hmm.
And mm-hmm. boosted die with it.
Well, see, yeah. that's the nice thing I think people tend to forget about that about the Mortar Crew is, yeah, they're horribly inaccurate. They're very rarely actually going to hit the thing they're aiming for, but when they deviate, they do POW 8. POW 8 blast damage is really solid at killing most infantry.
Yes.
Yep.
So, you know, deviate some of those blast 8... Or those POW 8 blast damage templates into somebody's infantry and just make him sad.
The first time I didn't realize I had that much range, I was playing Gore Shade against him, and he just completely blew my caster off the table within one shot. I was like, what was that?
He pretty much was like mopping my infantry like it's nothing. I'm like,
I don't know. Banes, kill this, kill that.
So I was like, screw it.
He's like, boom. Gore Shade's like,
what does he say? Straight dice damage, and I roll 14 total.
Yeah.
He
had like 2 hit points left. I'm like, ah! I'm like trying to run around. I'm like, I can't get out of his range no matter where I go. And
the Bombardiers got you.
Yeah. And
they have Arcane Fire. So I'm like I was near a base. And I was like, oh, they have Arcane Fire. It doesn't matter for threat.
That's the Troll's artillery problem. Is it doesn't have Arcane Fire, and we have a sea of medium bases.
Oh, it's true. You get in your own way a lot.
That sucks.
Well, you know, use the foe blades. Oh, you kill one of your guys. Well, my guys can
the
move
fin
up.
Blades?
Or the fin blades.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you mean Vengeance?
Yeah, Vengeance. There's one good thing.
It does have momentum, which knocks stuff down or slams it back, which is nice. But
we just have Ghost Shot. That's
yeah.
it.
Ghost Shot's bad. I hear being able to ignore everything in the world.
Well, it's not that. It's just that...
you don't have line of sight, sorry.
It doesn't have a great rat. And even with the guy next to it, it's still only rat 6. It's not...
Oh, ring rat. 14 inches.
Hey, at least you have an artillery piece. Circle's artillery piece is, and I kid you not...
Nothing.
It is the Sentry Stone and Mannequins. When they released all the artillery pieces, that was the circle entry for artillery, was the Sentry Stone and Mannequins.
I think it's their artillery because they expect people to throw it away.
So. Isn't it really cool you have a Mannequin and you can
actually, from the studying that I do, back in Mark 1, that thing used to be legit and the most broken of the artillery pieces
really?
In the game.
Wow.
And nowadays, now it's just kind of sad.
Yeah.
But,
Joyce had mentioned that she likes playing the Satixis Raiders and the Blood Witches, but she doesn't understand why they don't have, what is it, not Pathfinder, or what did she say?
Oh, okay, they run as fast as the whip-wielding sisters. The Blood Witches are just a little slower.
Yeah, she's like...
Maybe it's because the Texas Raiders keep hitting themselves with the whips, so they're, like, spurring themselves on. I don't know.
I like the Blood Witches. I think they're a lot of fun.
I loved them in the last game I played with Joyce.
I hate them all.
Joyce let me live a dream. It was amazing. She moved all of her Blood Witches up in this little clump. And she forgot that I had said that my caster has a spell that does POW 12 blast damage.
Oh, no.
And...
well, you didn't...
And also, my caster has a spell that allows her to collect one fury for every undead or living model that dies inside of her control area.
Was that Hellmouth that you hit her with?
No, it was even better. So she has them all. She has them all clumped up in this little spot, and I'm just like, well, I have an arc node. It's going to jump over here, and I'm going to go ahead and shoot that one Blood Witch with this spell. And it hits her, and I'm like, it costs 3 to cast a spell, and it's 1 to boost to make sure I hit. I'm like, okay, it hits her. It does POW 13. It's POW 13 blast damage, actually. So it does POW 13 to her, and that's what their armor is. So she just immediately dies. I'm like, okay, and then what happens is I center this 3-inch AoE that's a forest on top of this model I just killed, and everything inside of that forest takes a POW 13. So 3 more Satixis Blood Witches died, and I collected 4 Fury, which was the amount of Fury that I had just spent to cast that spell. So I cast it again. Section of the unit and killed 4 more of them. Oh, it was hilarious.
Well, the you know, in Legion...
Noobs gotta learn.
Yeah. Don't worry, he's gonna get schooled today, so don't worry. He'll get his learning.
It's a great experience for Joyce, because now she knows never to clump her Satixis up like that again, because they die to blast damage.
Yeah, well, and we all have to learn that the hard way, I think, when we start playing. So but what I was going to say is, you know, caster-wise, I think a lot of people, especially Legion, don't like Ryas, and Ryas is my favorite caster.
Well, she is the worst ninja ever. She doesn't have Pathfinder, and that sword, as long as it is, doesn't have reach.
Apparently in Mark 1, she was awesome. So like, she was way better than Saren type thing. But I think they like swapped them, like who was the better caster, I guess. But with her, like, yes, she doesn't have stealth, but she can give herself stealth. It's like, eh. She doesn't have Pathfinder, which is totally crazy to me.
The ultimate defense against Ryas is to put your caster behind a wall.
Yeah.
And then she can't come get you.
but she ignores, you know, she's got acrobatics, she's got
parry,
she's got dash, when she gets to what she's going, I think what sold me on her so much is the first time I got a crit decap on someone's caster and killed them by like 87 points or something stupid. I'm like, what? But it's like, once you do that, it gets really addictive. You're like, I want to try it again.
I have a great story about that, actually. So two of our newer players were playing against each other, and one was playing, it was a circle on Legion match, and one was playing P. Kruger, and the other one was playing Ryas. And, the circle player, he takes P. Kruger, and in a desperation move, he charges Ryas to try and assassinate her. And he rolls his first attack, and he misses.
Oh,
so
no.
So she does the riposte attack back at him and gets a crit decap and kills him.
That would be... at that point, I'd be like, okay, new faction. All right, I'm done. Oh, man. That was the funniest
thing.
When you pull those off with Ryas, it really endears her to you. It really does. And I know a lot of people don't like her, and she's not... Is she a good tournament caster? No. But she is so much fun. Her air feet and everything with the throne and the Scythians, wherever, you know, hopping bases and doing all kinds of crazy. Like, it's just a fun caster. And she's simple. She's not complex at all. Her abilities make her the most complex. But her spell list, she's got 3 spells that are super simple. Boom. It's awesome.
No, actually, I like her. If I played Legion, I would definitely play her, because she is a very fun, active kind of caster. She gets into the fight. I like Grail in Circle a lot for the same reason. He's very much like her. Mm-hmm. Except he has Pathfinder, because he's an actually good ninja.
Some of my casters are solo as well, that can just go in and the fray. Like Butcher, that I can't wait to see.
Oh, man.
Is Butcher 3. Kill everything!
That's awesome. We've only got a couple more minutes left until we have to get to the game. So one of the things we definitely
have to do things here.
Yeah, we actually have to play a game tonight. So we're going to go and get to the model of the week. Now, the person who painted this model, which after I picked the model, I realized was the same guy who The one last week. Alabster was the guy's former name.
He has been properly reprimanded for this, but it will not happen again.
But one thing I love is, and this is endearing to me a little bit, is he did an Archangel, and I think it is probably one of the best Archangels I've ever seen. So let's go ahead and put it up on the screen. I've got four. He's put up four different images, so let's see what we got here. So that's the front there.
Oh, I've seen this Archangel.
That is
it's
so
really well done. It's beautiful.
That's probably my favorite Archangel I've seen to date. Now, let's see if we can get a different the different angles, because he gets it from different sides. And he actually, it's actually a custom too, because his arm, left arm is supposed to be in front of the body, and it's instead
right,
he's reaching
out.
Right,
he's got it kind of reaching out.
Yeah, which is kind of neat. So it almost looks a little bit like he's pointing, but yeah, really cool model. I love the look of this thing. It's really well done. So yeah, so awesome job. Yay, clapping.
So
let's figure out what we're
gonna do. Get more prizes.
Yeah. You'll have enough dice to, you can replace all the dice you have. So anyway, so that's a model of the week. And so this week, this game is going to be Jake versus me and Cato versus Legion. I'm going to play three Liliths. I'm going to try it out and see if I can get a caster killing or something. So good chance to show people what she's like.
And I'm playing Epic Orusk. And we normally don't do this. We discuss we never do this. But I think this model's coming out on June 19th, the Iron Fang Covenant, and I want to show off people like how show the mobility on your Man of War, Shock Troopers, and the Iron Fangs.
And people will get to see my Green Archangel for this battle, so.
Right.
Because someone asked to see that last week.
It is painful to the eyes, so don't look directly at it. Kind of look at it from an angle.
Whatever.
I'm gonna laugh in the videos like, I can't see it. It blends in on the ground.
Oh, this thing glows. Yeah. It's ridiculous. All right,
so let's go ahead and get to the game, start the video, or let's do this.